Hello and welcome back. This is Sundar and this is gonna be the second video of our two-part video series. And in this video, we are gonna be learning how the anti-geometry, which namely anti-squat and anti-dive, what is gonna be the geometry? If your wheel is rotating in this direction, which means that your brake rotor is also rotating in this direction, right? So now if you apply brakes, okay, if you apply brakes, what will happen is it'll try to pull, the brake rotor will try to pull your knuckle in this direction, right? So that's a brake force that is acting onto the caliper, okay, from the rotor side. So your knuckle, your brake caliper tries to reduce the speed of your brake rotor. And since the brake rotor is actually moving with the wheels, it'll try to pull the knuckle in this direction. Okay, the transfer that is acting onto your vehicle, this load transfer and the brake force, these two combined tries to pull the upper arm this direction and tries to push the lower arm in this direction. So this force what is created, that is actually acting onto the lower arm and from there to the chassis, that pushes the rear part of the car upward, and that is what it actually causes this pitching motion. Okay. So this is what happens, and this mechanism what you just saw is what we call it as a diving mechanism. Now let's try to understand what squatting is, squat mechanism. Okay, so squat mechanism is nothing but it's exactly same as the diving mechanism, just in reverse, which means that instead of the dropping happening onto the front side of the car, the dropping happens onto the rear side of the car. It's exact same. It's whenever you accelerate. So whenever you, the squatting happens whenever you suddenly give an acceleration, and diving happens when you brake. Okay, so that's the difference. So it's exactly same mechanism. It's just it's instead of the front wheels, it's actually acting onto the rear wheels, and squatting doesn't have the braking force in that. This is just a live this is just a comparison video of so the left one here has a squatting and diving, and the right one here, it has 100% anti-squat and anti-dive. Okay, so now just try to see, whenever you try to brake, okay, the front portion compresses, okay, the front portion compresses, and on the right hand side car, the front portion remains still. Okay, so this actually has an 100% anti-dive when it's braking, and when it's accelerating, the front portion kind of lifts up on the left side car, and on the right side car it actually remains at the same height, right? So this is the difference between 100% anti-squat and anti-dive, and the other cars having some squatting and diving.